The Galaxy S8 was a real head-turner when it landed in our laps back in the first half of 2017, and despite an onslaught of devices from notable rivals, it's still one of the best phones you can buy right now. For starters, this phone still stands out from the crowd. That smooth, rounded frame looks and feels luxurious in the hand, and the overall form and dimensions mean it's still a rarity against these scores of wider, squatter handsets out there. It should come as no surprise that the phone's glossy body attracts fingerprints as readily as ever, and unprotected, the Gorilla Glass won't put up much of a fight when trying to repel scratches and scrapes, but at least the metal frame on our handset still looks practically unscathed. The rear-mounted fingerprint sensor, a departure from Samsung's previous efforts, is pleasantly responsive and convenient for right-handed users, but less so for lefties, whilst the phone's IP68 dust and water resistance is an ongoing blessing that the company could have shouted about more when the phone first launched. Whilst phones like the LG G6 and iPhone X have since arrived on the screen with similarly elongated displays, the 5.8-inch 18.5x9 Quad HD Plus Super AMOLED Infinity display on the S8 is still one of the best in the business. The aspect ratio makes it great for watching movies, although admittedly it displays a smaller overall image when showing 16x9 formatted content compared to more conventional 5.5-inch panels. As for viewing angles, there's little else out there to rival its stability and fidelity, with consistently strong overall brightness making outdoor use a breeze. Aesthetically, the minimal bezels, how it curves away at the edges and rounds out at the corners all help support the overall cutting-edge look of the phone, and under finger, it adds to the sense of satisfaction you get as you swipe around the responsive interface too. It feels cool as hell in everyday use, and right now no other phone really comes close to replicating that sensation. The audio experience, however, is less impressive. Whilst the phone's single downward-facing loudspeaker is perfectly capable of pushing out clear, clean audio, its position means you have to cup your hand to direct the sound at your face. The likes of the iPhone 8 and the HTC U11 both offer excellent dual speaker setups, and it feels like Samsung could have done something similar but either didn't deem it important enough or just didn't have the time. The S8 and S8 Plus launched on Android 7.0, and while some handsets like Google's own Pixel phones are now running on the next major release of the OS already, an update for Samsung's flagships is expected to hit any day now. Despite lacking a few new goodies like additional emoji support, after repeat use, Samsung's heavily skinned Android interface isn't all that bad. We weren't initially sure whether the stylized iconography was a little too contrived, and depending on who you ask, it may still be. But overall, TouchWiz makes for a simple and snappy way to navigate the phone's expansive screen. One-handed mode is a welcome essential, as is the hidden haptic home button. Samsung's also added little accoutrements to the software that nobody asked for but seemed genuinely powerful and useful, like its scroll capture screenshots, game launcher edge screens, and offset split screen view, to name a few. We're still not sold on Bixby though, especially being bound to a physical button that you can't change to do anything else. It shouldn't come as a surprise that the Exynos 8895 processor and 4GB of RAM inside this thing mean that it still feels as tight as ever. We hold our breath every time a new software update hits, expecting its fluidity to start wavering. But whilst it's not necessarily the beefiest phone on paper anymore, in everyday use it's still rock solid. Battery life is really where the question mark hangs, as it can take time to break a phone's power plant in properly. Thankfully, the S8 has proved consistent in its longevity, with a day's usage comfortably falling within the 3000 mAh cell's means. It's not groundbreaking, but it'll be sufficient for most users, and the S8 also happens to be one of the few phones that supports integrated wireless charging, as well as fast wired and wireless charging support too, something that you'd undoubtedly miss were it taken away. Somehow, Samsung made the sterling camera setup on the S7 better in the S8, and whilst it doesn't feature a dual sensor like a growing number of rivals, it's still one of the best smartphone snappers around, if not the best. It can take a great photo in almost any environment, works incredibly well in low light, shoots up to 4K video without breaking a sweat, supports manual control, supports additional downloadable shooting modes, and throws in some fun features too. It does it all, and it does it really, really well. Spending more time with the S8 has just cemented in our minds how good a camera it possesses. The Samsung Galaxy S8 is still one of the most capable options on the market, and one of the reasons to buy it right now is that it's dropped in price significantly. Coming in at around £500 in some places is enough to give rivals like the OnePlus 5T cause for concern, and undercutting new competitors like the iPhone X by a country mile without compromising on quality of capabilities means this might be the flagship to buy right now. Hopefully you liked this long-term review of the Samsung Galaxy S8, and if you want to know more about this phone or anything else that's on the market right now, you can read about it on Recombo.com and watch it on Recombo.com's YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell for notifications, and thanks for watching.